question is for Frank. Last month, you amended your personal financial disclosure form to include personal savings of between $250,000 and $500,000 that was not previously listed on the form. Could you please explain this action to the audience?
Sure. We have financial disclosure reports that, as candidates, we have to file. There's about 140 pages worth of rules and regulations for a five-page document. There were several mistakes that I had made on my disclosure, not just including what financial components to report and what not to report, but also the period of time that I filed, as well as the boards that I served on, like Liberty House and Manchester Veterans Homeless Shelter. When I identified that I made some mistakes, I amended the report voluntarily, made sure that our legal counsel ensured that it was properly filed. I spoke with the House Ethics, the House Clerks Committee, as well as the FEC to make sure that we had done it properly. And that was done voluntarily by myself several months ago.
John, any comment?
No, I just think that ethics are really vitally important in this cycle. We need to make sure that Republicans are trusted again, especially when you see people like Charlie Rangel, Maxine Waters. This is a golden opportunity for us to defeat Carol Shapewater. I want to make sure we have a nominee that is free of ethical concerns or clouds over their candidacy. And I think we do ourselves a disservice when there are still ethical questions that are lingering around candidates. This is really a time when people distrust members in public service, particularly the politicians in Washington. We got to ensure that we regain their trust.
Rich?
As I mentioned, this is the first time I've run. And there were things about running that I fully expected. One of them that was a little disconcerting was being asked to disclose where my income comes from, like my, you know, we're New Hampshire people, right? We like our privacy. But I realize there is a purpose for it. And the purpose for it is to be above reproach. And I believe it's a process that can serve to do that. And we need to work it up now and find it to be above reproach, because Carol Shapewater is stockpiling her dollars and is waiting for September 15th to unload on where the nominee is. And we need to ensure get this right in the primary, because we're not going to have much time in the 6 weeks after the primary 15. To defend ourselves. I believe I've complied completely. That's the goal.
Bob?
I truly believe that politics is the residuum of trust. When people vote for you, they put in your hands their trust, and I think you need to be completely and 100% above approach to ask for their trust. I don't know about anybody else, but I wouldn't forget a $250,000 or $500,000 account that I had. I just wouldn't. And what puzzles me is the numerous requests that have been laid at your feet, Frank, to show the bank statements that you say exist. I've been involved in politics since I was 17 years old, and I have never seen a politician who would not want to get rid of this subject as fast as hell. And that's the fastest way of doing it. And I'm puzzled by not wanting to show those right.
Frank?
Well, I've served this state in many different capacities as a state legislator, as an alderman, and most recently as a mayor. I'm used to getting hit and attacked by Democrats. I think this issue is an important issue. And there are other people here on the stage who also made errors in their financial disclosures. I don't bring those issues up because this campaign is supposed to be about the issues that our country is focusing on, how we can restore faith in Congress and ensure that taxpayers have a voice. I voluntarily amended a report, something that other people on this stage have also done. I don't think they did it with any other intention than trying to amend errors. And I offer that voluntarily without anyone asking me to do it. And I've done that. And these races, while it's tough to talk about personal issues, I'm happy to talk about it because I do want to support the people in this room. as your nominee, as your member of Congress. And I've complied with the law, and I've ensured that others here have complied with the law as well.
And next question. Caitlin has the next question.